Baldur's Gate 3 has raked in many awards at the Game Awards, and with Honor Mode now officially out, we can only say that the hype levels are through the roofs. Honor Mode has unfortunately, however, introduced existential crises all over the world. Due to people not knowing how to approach this game anymore, people keep wiping their party like baboons, resulting in premature endings of their playthrough. A lot of tears are subsequently the result of said tragedy. Now, I made a video about a very powerful party that can tackle on Honor Mode, and you guys liked it a lot. So today I'm going to go over another party composition that can destroy Honor Mode as well. The destruction of Honor Mode will be to such a degree with this party that afterwards you will simply call it Easy Mode. And let's be honest, the more parties we can create to destroy Honor Mode, the better. As always, our team will consist of the Frontliner, the Striker, the Blaster and the Controller. And we're going to start off with the Frontliner, being a Battlemaster fighter for this party. Yes, Battlemaster fighters are incredible in Baldur's Gate 3. You can really just go 12 pure fighter and be all good. Trust me, you don't even need to worry about multiclassing. Multiclassing? What is that? Or you can do a little Nutella dip and get a level in War Domain Cleric to get those War Priest extra attack charges like I advocated for on my channel. Reason is because War Priest extra attack charges give you extra attacks as a bonus action, which is huge for a fighter considering a lot of their identity revolves around dishing out a lot of damage in one turn through multiple attacks, and that's because fighters get a whopping 3 attacks per turn on their main action, which can be easily turned into 6 attacks through action surge, so the synergy with a War Domain Cleric is really good. Fighters also get ridiculous damage output, as it's a great idea to utilize Great Weapon Master on them, and they wield big ass swords, and with multiple attacks per turn, well, it is a great recipe for success. Don't forget, Battlemaster fighters get a lot of CC in the form of their maneuvers as well, that can completely change the tides of the battles that you will engage in. And these maneuvers hit extra hard, so you want to definitely utilize them. With my setup, you will also just be all over the battlefield, you'll have insane jumps, insane main character syndrome, and just general presence like a boss. The dip in Cleric also gives us the opportunity to utilize Sanctuary, which is absolutely amazing, because you can attack 3 to 6 times in a row, cast Sanctuary, chill a bit, and make everyone on the other team skip their turn entirely. You have great sustain and defense through our gear, and then also the earlier mentioned CC and damage, making you a great option for a frontliner. If you want to know how to progress a fighter and just all the details, gear, leveling choices and such, check out my Battlemaster fighter for a full guide. Link for it will be in the description. Next up, we're going to go with the Blaster. Any good party has some kind of mage-esque figure that can just blow things up and be successful while doing so. Who is this mysterious individual going to be, you ask? Well, that will be revealed in a second. But first, a word of today's sponsor, the one and only Old School RuneScape. Leagues 4 Trailblazer is Old School RuneScape's latest league, a seasonal game mode which runs until mid-January. Leagues are a fast-paced version of Old School RuneScape where you can wield more power than ever before. We're talking huge XP boosts, loot drops and powerful relics which offer various buffs and abilities, and they will all speed up your progress and change the game in ways you couldn't imagine. Player counts are higher than they've ever been before because lots of people are starting fresh, and therefore it really is the best time to try out Old School RuneScape. Check the link in the description for more information. For Blaster, we're going to go with a Draconic Sorcerer that wields 2 staves, not just 1, 2. This provides you dual wielding the 2 arguably strongest staves in the game, the Mark of Heshkir and the Staff of Spellpower, in turn giving you insane power. Now, everybody knows sorcerers have great burst damage. Fireball, Chain Lightning, Disintegrate, you name it. But when you use the Arcane Battery of these staves, you have the option to free cast level 6 spells back to back. Combine it with meta magic of a sorcerer that allows you to twin abilities like Chain Lightning or Disintegrate, and you get insane clears of enemies within just 1 turn. Keep in mind that the sorcerer isn't even just about attacking once per turn. No, you have haste, you have quickened meta magic, usually ingrained in your kit, of which both allow you to attack multiple times per turn. A bit like a Battlemaster fighter, one might say, but that's not where the power of the sorcerer ends, obviously. Casting level 6 spells for free, twinning big bursty spells and such is nice, but we also get great utility. You want to basically just cheat and give you and your entire team immortality while killing off your enemies? You can do so. Wanna troll enemies and negate their most annoying spells? Included. Wanna throw people from one side of the battlefield to the other side of the galaxy to insta-kill quest-related characters or powerful enemies? Done. You want to bully your enemies and make them move through clouds of death? Those are just a few examples of what a powerful sword hurt can do, and obviously we always still have Fireball for those good old AoE nukes. If you want to build a powerful sword hurt, go ahead and check my dual staff monster sword hurt build for all the details and step-by-step breakdown of how to do such a thing. For our controller, we're going to go with the Cleric. Cleric is absolutely busted in Baldur's Gate 3, it's easily one of the best classes. Clerics have everything really: CC, support, heals, feasts, control damage, and thus it fits the controller spot absolutely perfect. It can control the flow of enemies' movement and their ability to cast or just attack, and more generally speaking, just keeps enemies in check. But don't get it twisted, Cleric is a great damage dealer as well, and does so in a way that it can still heal and use CC while damaging enemies, and that synergy is amazing for the controller in your party. For example, True Spirit Guardians, which is an amazing ability that destroys everything in its radius and can just wipe out enemies altogether while you don't neglect your more support-esque type of duties, because it is a concentration spell. Spirit Guardians is obtained so relatively early on as well that this single ability spikes the power of Cleric through insanity by itself. Make sure you have high constitution and get relevant feats like Resilient Constitution or Warcaster that give you a higher chance to maintain your concentration spells as long as possible, and you are set. And you'll have plenty of damage anyways and plenty of healing as well. And then you also have the option to modify your healing through the variety of gear in the game that ingrains powerful buffs in your heals, but also a Cleric provides you great utility in the form of things like aid that in itself can add hundreds of HP to your party when upcasted, but also things like Heroic Feast that gives you a nice big buff, and that buff consists out of extra HP, your team not being able to get annoying diseases, as well as giving you advantage on one of the most important ability related saving throws in the game, Wisdom. Those again are just a few examples of how great of a support and controller type of character a Cleric can be. Full 1 to 12 guide with every single detail you need for making a powerful Cleric will be in the description. Finally, we have one more spot left in our team, and it's going to be the Striker, which in this case is going to be a Ranger, multi-classing with Rogue and Fighter for optimal damage. This build is truly the definition of what a powerful Striker needs to be. Insane single target damage with many attacks in a single turn from a distance. And that last bit is very important because it gives you huge flexibility in who you want to target and kill. And also because it's a dexterity-based build, your initiative is going to be really high, and from my experience, you will always just have the first turn with your Striker. Mixing Rogue with Ranger for a Ranger is a great combo because it gives you an additional bonus action through Fast Hands, and we are definitely going to utilize both our action and bonus actions because both of them equal to shooting a bolt. This is because this build makes use of dual wielding hand crossbows, where your main hand is your main action and your offhand is your bonus action essentially. Through feats like Sharpshooter, we then absolutely spike our damage output as high as possible, and through having Action Surge from the Fighter, we can get even more attacks in a single turn. The range maneuvers from Fighter give us also CC options, and in fact are the harder hitting shots, while we also can benefit from sneak attacks for those sneak buffed hits through the Rogue in us. And if you want to know everything about this epic build and the optimal progression path that I laid out for it so you can destroy the entire game, make sure to watch my video for it. The full guide will tell you everything you need to know to actually replicate the build in your game. And this is another party that synergizes really well. The various members complement each other, and each party member fulfills a certain role that is needed for a team. Striker having that ranged physical DPS to start off with, Blaster having that magical DPS with high burst and utility, Frontliner being tanky and is in our enemies' faces with great melee DPS, and the controller supports the team wherever needed, while also having a scary presence of their own on the battlefield. So great choices all around the board. Let me know if you want more party-oriented videos like this for Honor Mode. Make sure to give the video a like, subscribe if you haven't done so yet, and if you want to support the channel, make sure to become a Patreon. You will also find written guides for all my builds on my Patreon. Thank you for watching. Thanks to Jagex for sponsoring this video. Remember, check out leaks for Trailblazer Reloaded for a new way to play RuneScape with huge XP and loot boosts, and insane buffs and power-ups. Link will be in the description.